Today you need to confess the mysteries of the word. Praise God. And then you will see what God will do for you here today. By the anointing, Jesus is here by His Spirit, that the Holy Ghost. He's doing several things here through the preaching of the word to the meek. If I read it, he says, the Spirit of God is upon me because He has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. Now, who is the meek? The meek here is the humble person, isn't it? Who is the meek? The meek is the humble person here. He says, I want me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of prison to them that are bound. Then verse 2, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all the mourn. Then verse 3 says, to appoint unto them the mourn, to appoint unto them the mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that He might be glorified. And they shall build the old wastes. There is someone in this place, you're going to build the old waste. Amen. The things that have been wasted, you're going to rebuild them in the name of Jesus. Amen. I prophesy to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. This night we are in the presence, and in this presence of God, I want you to take by faith and begin to receive whatever I speak according to the word of God here in the name of Jesus. Amen. How many of you know that Jesus is here? Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus is here. According to this scripture, the first thing Jesus has come to do here by His Spirit is to heal the brokenhearted. Apart from preaching the good news to the meek, whoever is humble here will receive. Oh, my Father. There is somebody who came here with a broken heart. You are brokenhearted. But I want to tell you that Jesus can fix it. Amen. I said Jesus can fix it. Amen. There is no heart Jesus cannot fix, because Jesus made the heart. So when you begin to grieve and your heart is broken by anything or any circumstance, Jesus Christ can heal the broken heart. See, you begin to see that Jesus can heal broken hearts, you will not be able to be healed. I said, and then you have to confess it, that Jesus can heal your broken heart, and then you begin to possess it. The Spirit of God is whispering to me that there are people here, you came specifically because your hearts are broken. And Jesus led you to be here, to come to this place today, because the heart of the King is in the hand of God. Do you know that several people have more emotional problems than physical problems? But there is something Jesus is here doing to them. Jesus is healing broken hearts here. Amen. He's healing broken hearts. Now. You know, that thing declined and written, accepted, is a reversal of somebody's situation. And I claim that for my life in Jesus' name. If you look at that scripture we read, He's here to declare liberty to the captives. There are many people who are captives. Many people are captives, but they don't know they are captives. So many people are captives in their lives. You can go to your seat, my brother. You could be captive to an issue. You can be captive to an addiction. You know that if your liberty is not declared, you cannot be released. If the judge does not declare you're free, you cannot be in prison. I don't know if you know that. But today, Jesus is declaring liberty for somebody here in the name of Jesus. He's the King of the universe, and he's the King of all the kings. He's the judge, and prisons answer to him. From the court of heaven, he has proclaimed liberty today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So take it. Are you in any form of captivity? Are you in any form of captivity? Financial captivity? Spiritual captivity? Have witches bound your life? But from the court of heaven today, I declare amnesty for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I pray you will take it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know, if a judge or a president declares an amnesty and you do not take it, you remain where you are.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Hello?
Hi.
The Bible is telling me there is a declaration of amnesty today, and if you don't take it, your situation remains the way it is. This is a spiritual thing. This is not a physical thing. You know, Christians baffle me sometimes. You know, you go to a native doctor, or a witch doctor, or a card reader, and they take something and give you a card, and they tell you that it is well with you. You go home rejoicing, isn't it? Hello? Or you go to a doctor, you have such a sickness, the doctor finishes and tell you, well, you have a clean slate. Even if you're dying and the doctor says you have a clean slate, you stand up, you begin to rejoice. Hello? The way we proclaim the word of God to people, they stay and they're quiet. They don't rejoice, right? And that is why people don't have breakthrough. Do you understand me? Do you know that somebody can be so sick and the doctor can just give you chalk? You know chalk? You know doctors do that. They look at you, they think your sickness is psychological. They know that you're really not sick. You know, doctors do it. They just give you chalk. They have medicine like that called chalk. And they just give it to you, and you feel well. You see how men can believe in ordinary men, but can't believe in the medicine of all medicines, the word of God. You guys are so plastic here today. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I declare liberty for somebody in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
This one he has done for you. He has not only proclaimed liberty or proclaimed amnesty for you, he has commanded the prison door to be opened.
Amen.
Can I read it further? He says, to proclaim liberty to the captives and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. Now, you know they can proclaim liberty for you. Hello? And then they can an opening of the prison to them that are bound, and they can open your prison and you're still there. Why? Because in the first place, you do not know you have amnesty. Number two, you don't know you've been set free. Some of us have stayed so much in prison of life that when our liberty comes, we still don't believe it. I will show you people here about God changing the client that set. Some of you guys, you don't know how to claim promises. Oh, that was why David was extraordinary. David will rejoice and begin to dance before the Lord for any promise God gives him. I thought that people should have been screaming and enjoying themselves and say, Lord, thank you for turning my decline to acceptance. May God have mercy on us.
Amen.
He has not only proclaimed amnesty for you, he has commanded the prison doors to be open.
Amen.
In the book of Acts, we found where he commanded the prison doors to be open. To be open for Peter, to be open for Paul. The prison doors opened on their own accord. There is a God that can command spiritual prisons to open.
Amen.
And even physical prisons.
Amen.
The prisons can open. Are you in any kind of prison here today? No, today that every prison holding you captive has been opened in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Now, the prison door can be opened, but you may not be able to come out because you're chained. You begin to understand.
Yes.
The prison door might be opened for you, but you may not be able to come out because you're chained. And that was why when the angel went to help Peter, the first thing the angel did was to make sure that the chains were broken. And that is why I'm prophesying to somebody here, because the Spirit of God is upon me here today to declare every chain binding everybody in this place, both physical, both spiritual, in the name.